Chronic diseases such as Alzheimer's disease, we really don't understand what causes the disease. In some people, about 5% of the population, there's a genetic cause and those people will get the disease. However, for most of the population, we don't understand why they get the disease. So my research is trying to understand how lifestyle factors can influence your risk to get Alzheimer's disease. And in particular, I'm investigating the links between obstructive sleep apnea and the development of Alzheimer's disease.
So we're developing new ways to activate our own body's immune system to target cancers instead of just relying on chemotherapeutic agents to kill every single cancer cells in the body. What we are hoping to achieve is to allow our body's immune system to kind of take over at the end of that chemotherapeutic treatment period so that our immune cells can come around and clear out the residual cancer cells.
So our stem cells are the ones which generate all of the other cells in our bodies. So what we're trying to understand in our lab is how your brain's stem cells, our neural stem cells, develop and grow and produce the mature neurons at the right time and the right place for our brains to function. So we're doing research predominantly on autism at the moment and also macrocephaly and microcephaly. So again, we're trying to understand the biology of neural stem cells and how inappropriate trajectories of neural stem cell development give rise to these disorders.
There's a large number of people who are at risk of developing this disease. We don't know that they all get the disease for the same reasons. It's possible that everybody has a slightly different reason for developing the disease, and we may have to invent a number of different treatments or lifestyle changes that prevent the disease. And to get those treatments, we need to understand what's causing the disease and put a stop to it early.
There's still a lot of work that needs to be done in terms of completely eradicating this disease. Cancer cells, they mutate, they change the characteristic quite quickly as well, which makes them a really difficult disease to treat.
With some of the more severe disorders, some of the neurological disorders like autism, we are a long way from solving them. So I have hope that within, 20, 50 years, we'll be at a position where we're in a much better place to be able to treat some of those really debilitating disorders which can affect the patient obviously, but also their families over a long period of time.